Welcome back to my channel and welcome if you're new here. Happy Friday. It is Friday, so it is my virtual workshop day as well as the day that I weigh in at home and record my weight in my WW app. So I've already weighed in this morning. I'll be sharing those results with you after I attend my virtual workshop. But before I do that, I wanted to talk with you guys a little bit about my week. So as you know, last week I was on a little bit of the struggle bus, really just involving cake more than anything. But this week I was actually able to overcome a lot of those cravings for bad food or not good for you food like cake. So I did really well this week with overcoming those cravings. I was able to stay on track most of the week. I did Jazzercise 3 times, I believe. And yesterday we did a ton of walking. We're in the market for some new appliances. I know that I shared with you guys that our over the range microwave died and we finally got an okay from our home warranty company to go ahead and purchase a new over the range microwave. Well, they don't have one in stock, so they are having us purchase it and then they're reimbursing us within 20 days. Seriously, like you'll take my money, but it takes you 20 days to give me back the $600. So we are in the market for a new microwave, which then prompted us to be in the market for all new appliances. So yesterday we spent all day looking around. Today we're going to go back and make the purchase. With the pandemic, everything is on severe back order. So we ended up buying a cheapy little $50 microwave to sit on our countertop. So long story short, I got a lot of steps in yesterday with walking from store to store looking at appliances. So my activity for the week was really well. Yesterday was kind of a weird eating day. We actually went out for lunch and then I had leftovers for dinner. So it was kind of a strange eating day, but overall my eating and my exercise was pretty good. So I'm hoping to have some good results on the scale this week. So with that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and attend my virtual workshop and I'll be back to share what we talked about as well as my weigh-in results. On a run from my given disaster. I am out of my virtual workshop. It was fabulous as always. So incredibly nice to see the faces of all of my WW friends. And the topic was absolutely exactly what we needed. And this is talking about control versus what we can control and what we can't control. And I know that a lot of us are just feeling kind of out of the driver's seat right now when it comes to control over so many things in our life. Not only control over finances, jobs, going out and about, seeing friends and family, it can be really discouraging and we can feel really out of control right now. So we talked about what we can't control, what we can control, and how to kind of navigate through this crazy time. So first we talked about things that we can't control. And let me tell you, there is an array of things right now in our lives that we can't control. One is government decisions. We can't control what the government decides, such as stay-at-home orders, whether or not your business is essential, non-essential. We also can't control what's in the grocery store, what we can buy, what we can't buy. The list goes on and on. There's so many things right now that we can't control. But the more time we spend focusing on those things, the things that we can't control, the less time we're focusing on the things that we can control. So I think we need to really take a step back and stop focusing on those things that are out of our control and really taking a closer look at the things we can control, focusing on those. And it's a proven fact that when we feel in control, no matter what aspect of our life that control comes in, I mean, it could be something as simple as what our kids are doing, or maybe what our spouse is doing, or control over our job, or control over what we're buying at the grocery store. We feel much more happier and satisfied when we feel in control. And right now, most of us feel out of control. On a scale of 1 to 10, think about how you feel in control. 1 being absolutely out of control, and 10 being absolutely in control. For me, I feel like I fall about the midway point at about a 5. There are a lot of things that I can't control in my life, and I really honestly am doing a fairly good job of not focusing on those things. And then there's a lot of things that I can control. And I want to talk with you guys about the things that we can control. So that's what puts me kind of right in the middle at about a 5. And again, I'm really trying my darndest to focus on the things that I can control. So I'm trying to really zone in on what's in front of me. What can I control in the present moment? And some of those things are, I can control the food that not only comes in my house, but I can control the food that goes into my mouth. Now, am I gonna maybe be able to get everything I really, really want at the grocery store? Maybe not. There may be some things that are unavailable, but I'm going to find a substitution, or I'm going to revamp whatever I had in mind for that particular grocery item. So I can still control the food that I'm putting in my cart that's making its way into my house and what I'm putting into my mouth. And we talked last week about the cake debacle. And if I just don't bring those foods into my house, then obviously I can't eat those foods. And I'm certainly not going to get in my car, drive to the grocery store when I don't need to be going out into the grocery store to pick up those foods that I shouldn't have anyways. So it's actually a good time to control the food that's going into your house, because we have less control over what we can and can't go to the store to pick up. I can also control tracking. I can control tracking my food. That's 100% in my control. So I have promised myself that I'm going to track my food every day, good, bad. I'm going to track everything that goes into my mouth, because that is a piece of my journey that I can absolutely control. And that is essential, of course, to being successful on any weight loss journey, is taking note or tracking your food. And I have been double tracking both in the WW app and also in the Lose It Calorie Counter app to kind of see where I'm falling calories versus points. And it's been interesting. I will tell you guys that I'm going to be sharing in a future video comparing calories versus points when you're really focusing on clean whole food. So I don't really want to get into that in this video, but I'll just say it's been quite interesting. And another thing that I can control that I've been doing that is not something that I did prior to the pandemic is I have been really focusing on positive self-talk. Every morning I am talking positively to myself. You have this. You can control the food that goes in your mouth. You're gonna do your jazzercise or whatever activity you're going to do today. It's going to be a great day. It's beautiful outside. And to be honest with you guys, I've noticed a difference in like my overall demeanor during the day by having that little bit of positive self-talk in the morning. So I've really been focusing on what I can control and having a little bit of a less focus on what I can't control. And with that, I do want to talk about the news. I think that the news, although it is information-based and we are getting some information from the media, I also feel that too much news watching can really negatively affect us, because I feel like the media sometimes over exaggerates on things, overdoes things. And I think if we're constantly watching the news morning, noon, and night, again, I think it can have a little bit of a negative impact. So I have been watching the news one time per day, and that's in the evening at dinner. My husband and I sit down and watch the news, and the rest of the time during the day, I'm watching things or focusing on positive things. I'm watching YouTube. I'm going on walks. I'm cleaning my house. I'm maybe trying some recipes I haven't tried before, and I'm keeping my TV off the news channel. And I think that that has really helped as well. So if you are struggling with watching, like binge watching the news and feeling like you're out of control or having negative thoughts, maybe take a little bit of a break each day from watching the news. So that's what we talked about in today's workshop, is just control and focusing on things we can control and having less of a focus on the media and things that we can't control. So I hope that that helps you guys. I hope that it gives you some ideas of some things that maybe you can modify to help you be a little bit more positive and feel a little bit more control right now. So I loved the topic. I think that focusing on what we can control is super important. I know we've talked about this in several weigh-in videos. It's actually been something that I've really been talking about. So way to go, WW, on bringing in another really important topic. So like I mentioned, I actually had a pretty good week this week. Yesterday, when we were appliance shopping, we did actually have lunch at Wendy's. So I did have a little bit higher sodium lunch, higher point lunch yesterday, but I still was within my overall points at the end of the day. But I don't like to eat that kind of food, you know, the day before weigh-in. But regardless, my week went well, jazzercise went well, and when I stepped on the scale, I'm happy to announce that I lost 1.4 pounds. Woo, woo. So I'm really, really happy with that. Any loss during this time, I will take it. So I'm really hoping to get back into normal life. Hopefully in May, we'll see kind of what happens with this virus, but it'd be great if life could go back to more of a normalcy in May. And I think most of us will see a little bit better progress in our weight loss journey once kind of life in the world goes back to normal. But I'm happy with the 1.4. So my goals for this upcoming week are to do my Jazzercise at least 3 times. I've already checked the schedule and written it on my to-do board in my office the days that I'm planning on doing Jazzercise. Also, I'm going to try to get in some activity the other days of the week by going on walks or doing things around my house that involve a lot of movement and steps, and also focusing on continuing to honestly track and double tracking in both the WW app and in the calorie counting app. So pretty simple goals. And I think the caveat or the most important part to this is I'm going to continue focusing on what I can control and telling myself positive thoughts every morning. That has really, really helped me out. So I hope that you guys are doing well. I know that this is a crazy time for all of us. I hope you're safe and you're healthy and you're just really taking to heart the things that you're hearing about with these virtual workshops and trying to implement those and making this journey just a little bit easier during this time. I do want to hear from you guys down in the comments. I want to know how your weigh-ins went. Was it what you expected? Did you gain? Did you lose? What are you struggling with? And are you struggling with control and feeling like you're completely out of control? And if so, hopefully these tips help you feel a little bit more in control. And if you're new to my channel, I'd love it if you would stick around, subscribe, hit the bell so you're notified whenever new videos are uploaded. I do a weigh-in video every Friday where I weigh in and recap whatever topic we discussed at the WW workshop. So definitely make sure you're subscribed and your bell is on. Check out that description box down below for the link to my website where I have all my recipes, as well as the link to head over and join my Facebook group. We'd love to have you be part of that community. I'm doing some fun extra little giveaways on both my website and Facebook group this month. So definitely make sure you are part of both of those. Give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoy these weigh-in videos and make sure you leave me the comments. I love interacting with you guys in the comment section. Thank you so much, you guys, for watching today's video. I hope it helps you feel a little bit more in control. I seriously love you guys and I think about you daily and I'm here for you with any questions or support that you need. That is what I'm here for. So thank you again for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye, friends.